In 2021, Nina Tonga came to us as an art curator here at Te Papa and invited us to show in the Threshold space here on level 4.
What was great about it is there wasn't any kind of restrictions put in place for us. We were brought to the space, the Threshold Gallery, which has this kind of suspended bridge above it. And we're able to walk around in between installation of another exhibition. So the space was empty and really dream big about what we wanted to create for that space. Being given the creative freedom to approach something where there wasn't any restrictions or perimeters was so, so cool.
Mm. The space is big. It's the widest space we've been offered, and we're really excited to have the kind of multiple viewing areas. But it's so big. The first time we came in, we just kind of like slumped against one wall and like looked back and looked around, going, "And what are we going to do? What are we going to do for this one?"
I don't think people really know that we don't know what we're going to do at that point. And we all sat there kind of a little bit stunned and nervous. But as time went on and we talked about it more, ideas just begin to grow.
Yeah, one of the exciting extra things we did when we first arrived here at Te Papa was get our EWP licences. Terry and I were the chosen drivers. And then we could come into the space and drive ourselves around and install it ourselves, which is something that we've always really loved doing, is having that hands-on approach to install and being able to put up the works and weave it and be in the space with each other is integral to our practice.
Something that really grounded us was going just across the way to Rongo Marairoa, the marae, and looking at Kura Te Warurewere's mahi called Papa Tuanuku, the floor detail, the interior and the exterior of the marae.
We knew that Kura was one of the only named wahine that had worked on the project. And then that kind of sparked our interest in our decision to look at whareke within Te Papa's collection. Thinking about the way in which whareke, taonga Māori, occupy space, they take up space in the wharenui, one of the few taongas that do so.
Cameron, one of the collection managers, showed us through Te Whareporta and pulled out some really amazing whareke. Some of them were really fine and some of them were made of harakeke and some of keke. Mm. And that was really beautiful to be able to see the patterns on those.
Mm. We were really attracted to the darker colours that crossed in a diagonal along, and I think that's something that we've tried to bring through in Takapo.
Mm. And then how they were woven in sections, that was really beautiful to be able to see. And just to be able to see these really fine mats that weren't necessarily put on the floor, we echoed that with Takapo, having it not touch the floor and be elevated. Yeah.
We always get excited about material and the patterns and looking at it through a kind of art and design lens. But also from a Te Ao Māori lens, these mats dictate space. They can change the kind of zone from neutral to ceremonial, or they can wrap precious objects, or they can really like elevate and shift what's going on in a room. And that was something we wanted to play with, push, extend with Takapo.
We needed to kind of deconstruct them in our minds, I guess, to figure out how the patterns were constructed. And so spent some time trying to reproduce some of those patterns. One of them in particular was a small Taweda whareke that we reproduced using the reflective tape. And so that was nice to get a really good feeling for what it looked like with the reflective material. And then when we did our mock-up down south in Bridget's studio, we tried to reproduce that on a larger scale and ended up flipping and reversing it and coming up with this, a different way of engaging with that niho niho pattern, which is, yeah, where you have a long strip that gets reproduced and makes these beautiful peaks.
Yeah.
And then when we flipped it, that's when the kaukau started coming through as well, which was really beautiful because those are patterns that we know and recognize in the research that we've done, and then to be able to create it in a large scale way was quite exciting.
To create a symmetrical work, we needed some work in the gallery because it wasn't square or symmetrical. So amazingly, Te Papa put in a new wall for us, and we got some pretty heavy duty steel around the edge that we could hook our J hooks onto and start to weave this whareke.
Each diagonal set has 120 strops, and each one is of a different length, and then we had to times that by 4, and so it needed kind of careful calculation as to the quantity that we needed, and I had a few sleepless nights wondering if we had ordered enough. So we have 6 kilometres of webbing, reflective webbing, and if we didn't have enough, there wasn't another opportunity to get more. I was really holding my breath for putting that first longest diagonal strop up, because if that wasn't long enough, then it would put everything else out.
Yeah, and we all ran those out together.
Yeah.
And it was fine.
Yeah.
And there was...
We had heaps.
Lots of extra.
Yeah.
Could be something cool like that.
Oh, and there you go.
Yeah.
Nice.
Oh, that's nice. Well, that's good.
We do this one.
Lighting is incredibly important, and so Mike and Don have done a really beautiful job, and were really lovely to work with because they listened to us and took on our vision and ran with it. I'd always talked about with the lighting, the dappled light underneath from the shadows being cast from the overhead lights, but I don't think we expected such an amazing pattern to be on the floor and for it to feel so immersive, of being both the work being above and below you. And I think Mike really drew that out.
We looked at how whareke can define sacred spaces and how that applies to the whare tangata, and the idea that we talked about with Ngahuia Murphy about te whare tangata being the threshold between te ao atua and te ao marama. So we look at the way in which the potential is seen in the dark kind of enclosed space below, as well as when you view it from the bridge, it lights up and acknowledges te ao marama and the potential that has come or been birthed from the space below. The work kind of freezes a moment in the process of weaving a whareke. So it doesn't fill the entire space, and it shows the process and the way in which it's usually woven from a central point and kind of goes out. And then if you imagine this as being able to be added to and extended further and further to fill a space.
It's the again, talking about potentials as the beginnings of ideas, even though this was so much effort and energy to even just get to this point, there's the potential for it to be extended and expanded.
It'd be interesting to see how people engage with it, eh? And where they hang out, whether it's on the bridge or right underneath it or to the side walls.
And kids,
yeah,
because they're often at a lower height. Not my kids, they're taller than me, but yeah.
And that recognisable aspect of using the J-hooks and the truck strops and the buckles, being able to relate to it in some way, I think is important. Walking around the corner and then seeing the giant tarp.
Yeah.
Big blanket.
I would be really happy and excited to hear the things that are inspired for people, that are triggered for people by spending time with the work, hearing their stories. Yeah, because it's nice to be able to present a thing, but really it kind of gets completed with the interaction with other people, and it's not complete on its own. So I'm quite excited about that. And quite often we have people contacting us and saying, oh, this did this for me, and that's so special. I love that.
Something I would like people to take away from Takapo is the value of Māori art and taonga Māori, and that uplifting these practices, and that that's a continuation, is an integral part of Te Ao Māori today.
I hope that we create works that whatever experience you're bringing from your own perspective, you can, there's some sort of in, whether it's materials or the concept or and even the kind of like different layers of concept, conceptual kind of thinking that goes into it. Hopefully people can get something out of it, even if it just looks interesting or it's a familiar material. Yeah, I hope we create art that's accessible.
I hope, I have to always put my educator hat on sometimes, and I hope that young people and people who want to make art in the future see our work and see that there are no boundaries to how they can connect to their Māori tanga or being a Māori practitioner, that whatever they do and whatever they make is important. That you can be inspired by the work of our ancestors and follow a continuum of art making that is of value and really is a way to talk about who you are.